Thank you, Chair. Honorable Madam President Rajavi, thank you for your coming and thank you so much for your struggle for a free Iran. Ladies and gentlemen, let me share with you some of my concerns related to the human rights situation in Iran. Despite 4 years in office, President Rouhani has not delivered on his campaign promise of greater respect of civil rights, political rights, and human rights. No, executions continue in Iran at a very high rate. The authorities continue to arrest and charge journalists, bloggers, and online media activists for exercising their rights of freedom of speech and expression. Hundreds of websites, including social media platforms such as Facebook and Twitter, remained blocked in Iran. The intelligence and security service heavily monitor citizens' activities on social media. Authorities continue to target independent unionists and restrict freedom of assembly and association. Iranian women face discrimination in personal status matters related to marriage, divorce, and child custody. Married women may not obtain a passport or travel outside the country without a written permission of their husbands. Child marriage continues, as a law allow girls to marry at 13 and boys at age of 15 years as well as at younger ages if authorized by a judge. Members of religious minorities, Sufis, Christians, and Muslims face discrimination in law and in practice, including education and employment. Members of minorities who spoke out against violations of their political, cultural, and linguistic rights faced arrest, torture, and other ill treatment, unfair trials, imprisonment, and in some cases, death penalty. The freedom of religion is an important right which should be respected because religion is a private choice and has to stay private. Every person should have the right to exercise his or her religion as long as this does not restrict or harm the right of another person. But the political Islam in Iran and the Islamic Penal Code, which continue to provide stoning as a method of execution, is a dangerous and misleading interpretation of religion, as the religion has turned into a political instrument. It is time for Iran to become a modern and civilized country. It is time to change. The power of the mullahs must end, and the criminal Iranian regime must force out of power. To reach these targets, the EU member states and the EU institutions have to change their views concerning the ruling regime in Tehran. I was happy to hear my colleagues, Ms. McIntyre and Mr. Faria, criticizing the EU-Iranian delegation. It is time that economic interests don't rule the world any longer. We should not forget the values we stand for. Let it bring me on a point. We should not make deals and business with criminals. This I mean when I look to Iran and to the EU. Thank you very much. Thank you.